Happy Mercedesing! In our today's video, I'm going to show you how to measure your pressures. You know that video I have done explaining you how to measure proper way your pressures. You can watch it here. There's the link. And there were someone of you telling me that I have everything explained in theory, but nothing could be seen how it's done actually on the car. Well, do you want to see it on the car? Here you're gonna see that. So in our today's video, we're going to be measuring pressures on our car. Just to remind ourselves, these are the pressures for the engines M102, M103, M104, M116, M117. Okay, now if we are clear and we know what we're talking about, now let's go to the video. Well, it's nothing hard, it's pretty straightforward. To do this video, you will be needing spanner 12 to unscrew the hoses, a dirty rag to absorb fuel, and some kind of a pressure gauge to measure the pressures, of course. Well, if you're doing this with one gauge only, with the fittings for both the system pressure and the control pressure at the same time, then you will also have a little valve, let's say it like that. The first pressure to be measured is the system pressure. This one you measure with your valve open, if you have that kind of a pressure gauge. As you do, as you start your car, you read your pressure, then you close the valve. And then your pressure must be diminished. So you can clearly see how much your differential pressure actually is. As for me, I'll be doing it with two pressure gauges. And okay, then enough talking. Let's go to the garage, shall we? Before doing anything on the system, remove the battery ground connection. At first, we will be measuring the system pressure. We need a spanner 12 and a dirty rag to absorb fuel. We unscrew the connection for the cold start valve, and there we will have to attach our pressure gauge and screw it in firmly. There must be no fuel leaks. We start the car and read the pressure from the pressure gauge. We attach the fitting and connect the pressure gauge. Again, we screw in firmly both the pressure gauge as well as the fitting for it. Again, we connect the battery ground. We start the car, let the engine stabilize, and observe if there are any leaks
or, what's more important, drop in pressure, and we read the control pressure. That way, you see the difference in pressures. We start the engine and the pressure must fall to between 3 and 3.2 bar. As we finish, we get everything back and start the car once again to see if there are any fuel leaks.
So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.